Forest, are you there? Are you awake? I want to tell you about the most wonderful dream I've just had. Oh, I found myself lying on a tree stump in a puddle of melted snow. It was cold and I began to shiver, but a single snowflake fell from the sky and it kissed me right on the nose. And with the warmth of gazing upon you, the surrounding winter blossomed into spring. We made our home in the heart of a willow tree. He didn't want to get rid of the cobwebs inside because he thought they looked nicer. In the days, we would flutter around the woods, foraging, befriending birds and insects alike. And in the nights, I would caress your twitching wings as you drifted off to sleep. And we would hold each other tightly, all cozy inside woven blankets of grass. And then one night, it became so windy, so loud, and so frightful. So we wrapped ourselves inside a cocoon, letting both our bodies dissolve. And that's when I woke up. And now I am here with you once again. Isn't that just the most wonderful thing?
Smooth, and I wasn't worried, but the deeper I went, the more sticks and sharp rocks appeared. You were waiting for me, and I could feel that you were waiting for me, and that's why I kept going.
It's been so long since I've had a conversation with somebody on the phone, or even sat in front of somebody and had an intimate conversation with somebody that didn't feel forced.
And this makes me realize that I've lost touch with myself and with everyone around me. laugh again, not with just anyone.
You can drive, I'm sure. Hi everyone, it's MUNE here. I just wanted to say thank you so much for supporting me, because for ever since I released TULPA, it has been a really crazy ride for me in navigating true life, and I've gotten to really have some answers towards the questions that I've been questioning for TULPA and for the entirety of my life. And I may not know the overall answers for everything, and I'm still figuring out a lot of things, but it's clearer to me now. And I just wanted to take this time to really thank all the collaborators, the remixers, the people who have lent their voices to me into creating TULPA REDUX. This whole EP, this remix EP, is dedicated to everybody that I've met on the internet and I've talked to ever since I was probably about 7 years old. I was a chronically online kid because in real life I didn't have anybody to talk to. So when I found out about the internet and found out about, you know, social websites, you know, that you could talk to others from overseas and such, I found way more people that could be more accepting of me, way more people that really accepted and embraced the weirdness of a 7-year-old kid. And I probably shouldn't have been allowed to talk to people that old, older than me, but thankfully nothing really bad happened. And I just got to know a lot of people that were really nice towards me, that I've never experienced when I was in school. And growing up, the people that I've talked to probably don't even remember me now, or they don't even know who I am or right now, because it's been such a long, long time. But it's not only for them as well, it's for the people that I'm still in contact with, people who I'm still talking to. And I really, really still appreciate all of the people that I'm talking to through the internet, because in Singapore, it is especially hard for me to speak about a lot of things in my life and a lot of my childhood trauma. I'm not saying everybody here is not that, you know, they don't want to hear it, but it is still hard because, you know, it's an Asian perspective, and I feel that other people from other countries, they could really just listen to it more. And it's been really eye-opening and also a bit upsetting, because I can't seem to really see the people that I'm talking to on the internet in real life. But it's also like a double-edged sword, and I am just so, I don't even know what to say, to really just express my deep-rooted support and appreciation for those who support me around the world. You have no idea how much that means to me. That means a really, really big deal for anyone who's listening to me, even from Singapore or wherever. I just really appreciate it, because making music, especially music like this, is something that is a way for me to cope, a way for me to express myself, a way for me to really just show the world that even with whatever life has thrown at you, as a child, you never really had a voice to speak up for yourself, and you couldn't pick a great family. So even with all of that, you can still survive it, and you can still just become a better person. And I'm still navigating through that. I'm not the best. I can't say that I'm healthy in whatever aspect, but I'm really just walking towards it. And there will obviously be setbacks. And I hope that, you know, whatever I'm saying now, whatever that I'm putting out through my music, will hopefully help someone. And I'm just grateful for all the support that has been thrown at me. And I just deeply, deeply am so grateful that I could be doing music, because it really, really is helping me and has helped me. Thank you so much.